Let me first start with congratulating Abhimanyu Ghosh and his team of what a remarkable work they do and have done for Indian branding. We have in India lots of very good brands, but to make them international and to make them recognized even in India, he has done a great job, and all of us are grateful. You have heard Professor McDonald. I learned a lot. Every time I hear him, I learn a lot. I have never been able to find out why people pay so much for goodwill. But they do. And people like Abhimanyu Ghosh do manage to raise the value. You heard Richard, who is doing a tremendous job for Britain. I have been involved with this organization for a very, very long time, even with its predecessor organization. And India and Britain are natural great partners. And today, what better opportunity than what is happening in the Brexit situation? But I would like to come to the Brexit situation, but let me first of all welcome you all who have come from India. Some of you represent some great companies in India. And India is on the march. We have a Prime Minister who perhaps is the biggest brand expert today in the world. He has raised India's profile in the world. Just 3 weeks ago, if you saw the G20 conference in Argentina, the only three prime heads of the government was there who were visible. Mr. Modi, Donald Trump, and the Chinese, Mr. Xi. And that makes all of us Indians very proud. I am not going into the question of political part of it, but I am very proud of the fact that an Indian Prime Minister has raised the profile of India. The last person who did was the late Mrs. Gandhi. And India has done a lot. The other greatest thing which India has achieved in the 70 years, that we are the only country in the subcontinent and perhaps in the world who have made democracy more important. People used to say, oh, there is a rigging in the election, this election, etc. There is no rigging. India has done marvelously well, and we have to recognize it. Elections will always happen. We always need that every now and then the governments change. And the only winner in any election, anywhere in the world, in my view, is always the voter, because he gets what he wants. The people who stand don't necessarily get what they want. But the voter is the winner. That comes me to Brexit. As you know, there is a great debate going on whether the referendum should be held again. I think personally it's madness even to think that. I have been and I am still a very pro-European, because people have forgotten, unfortunately, in Britain, a lot of them, that the whole concept of a united Europe was started by the late Winston Churchill, because after two world wars, everybody in Europe was fed up, and he suggested some kind of a combination. I was very happy that this happened. Even during the referendum 3 years ago, I campaigned and spoke for remaining in Europe. In my view, we should have even joined the Euro also, because Britain has one great strength: they know how to lead. And we should have been leading Europe, not even following. But we had our internal politics, which we want our parliament to be more superior than the European Parliament. You have got to give up something in order to be a part of the big thing. I do hope the Brexit goes through. I even tweeted a few weeks ago that you can always join again. There is nothing to stop it. But let us get out, let people who have voted to go out have their say whether they are better off or worse. There's nothing wrong with it. I still do, it will happen. And either way, I don't think people have any danger. There's a lot of newspapers, etc. You read, this will happen to the currency, this will happen to the... As long as people like Richard keep working hard, we will be doing great with the world, because they run a very good organization. So, I would like to welcome all of you who have come from India. You, as I said earlier, you represent good companies and very important companies. This is perhaps, if we have the Brexit, which I hope and I think we will, it will be a great opportunity for India to increase their trade with Britain. Britain is very keen. Now, from an Indian point of view, we have rather forgotten the old countries Britain used to be with. Now, these have become important. In the meantime, perhaps because of this, a lot of countries who used to be British colonies have done much better, because we just wanted to trade with the world instead of these things. So here is an opportunity for India and for you all to let us really gain from each other. In the world over, the politics is getting interesting. I mean, look at the United States. Now, I just learned, after looking at news on the iPhone, that Mr. Trump has finally agreed to make a deal with the Congress about, so that people can go back to work. These things need saving. We have a strong government. We will always have a strong government in India. And there is a huge opportunity. Make use of it. Enjoy your stay in Britain. Even the weather in this weekend is going to be nicer. the temperature is going up by 5 degrees. So good luck. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.